Aloha, this is Professor Susan Jarowski, and I'm going to show you how to use some of the Laulima tools that I use in my courses. I'm going to log on at laulima.hawaii.edu. I'm going to log on using my student account, so we'll all see what a student would see rather than the faculty view. So I'm going to log on clicking this button here. It's just off to the right on your screen. And now I'll get to My Active Sites. If you've taken more than one course in the UH system, either now or in the past, you'll see a row of active blue tabs on the front. If you don't see your current course, click on My Active Sites and it should list all of the courses you're taking now and in the past. I'm going to use as an example a course that I've previously taught. This is what my Laulima homepage looks like. I usually take out the announcements and I fill in the center part with a web page that contains all the material you'll need for each week. Before we look at that, let's take a look at the tools that I've provided for you and the left-hand nav bar. The first one will always take you to the home page, the current page for the class. Because I'm giving you an example of a course that's already been done, the home page is week 16. But I always list for you, and you can see week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4, week 5, etc., all of the prior courses, so you can always access the past materials. Let's say you were coming to this course for the first time. This is the page that you would see. Now, going back to this left-hand nav bar, you'd see that the second button I have for you here is a syllabus. Sometimes I have a link to a PDF file. Sometimes I make my syllabus into a web page. I'm always experimenting to see what works best with the students. Either way, you'll be able to look at the syllabus by clicking on the syllabus link. The third link down here says Discussion and Private Messages. We have graded discussions in our courses, because it's a great way for students, especially in an online course, to talk with each other. So you will see one of these discussion boards live at a time. For instance, the first one you'll see will be Discussion Board 1. Notice that it gives you a due date. All of the due dates for this particular one were due on a Tuesday, and they all closed at 10 in the morning. At this point, the discussion board locks, and that's why you see the gold lock by every single one of these discussion boards. That means it's done. And once it's done, I don't open it again, because the purpose of a discussion board is to talk with other students. So even if you have a really good excuse, I don't reopen this discussion board because the discussion is over and students won't go back to this. So discussion boards are always good for only 1 week, so please make sure you have a chance to do them on a timely basis. Tasks, tests, and surveys happens to be the next link I have here. I also have a number of quizzes in my courses, and you can see the list of the completed ones here. If this were a live course and you were taking a quiz that was active, it would not say finished, it would say open, and it would give you the dates here, open and due, how many tries you're allowed, and what your grade is. It also allows you to review your grade after all of the quizzes are done. Like the discussion board, the quizzes lock after 1 week, and I don't make the feedback available until it's locked for everyone. After that point, though, you can click Review, and you can see the answers and the feedback that shows you why that particular answer was correct. The next tool I have here is Assignments. All of my courses have assignments that need to be done, and what I have provided for you here is a link with information. Now this says the close date of assignment is passed, you can no longer submit an answer because this is a former course we're looking at, but if you were going to take this during a regular course, it would give you the open dates. I usually have a link that gives you the explicit instructions for the assignment, and when you're done, you would upload it through the very same assignment tool. So at the bottom, there would be a place for you to provide an attachment with your answer, with your paper, with your report or your memo, whatever the assignment is. So you not only get your assignment through the tool, but you upload it into the tool as well. The next link you'll see here is the gradebook. Everything that's graded comes to the gradebook. Now I will tell you that quizzes are normally graded automatically, so as soon as they end, which is a specific date for each class, boom, you'll see your score. Discussion boards, I usually grade within a week or two. Pretty much the discussion boards, you know what you're going to be getting, because if you didn't reply at all, you know you're getting a zero. If you replied only once, you know is the maximum amount of points you can get is seven. And if you've done the required two posts of about a paragraph each, you know you get the 10 points. So I'm not usually in a hurry to grade those as I am for the assignments. The assignments, I try to get back to you within 1 week. As you can see here, this is what the grades look like for my student self. I didn't do this assignment here, so I have no grade. And this allows me to keep track of what I'm doing and how I'm doing in the course. The next link you'll see here is the mail tool. This allows me to email you, and it allows you to email other students. I also have an email archive for each of my courses. This means that every time I send a group email, I also send it to the email archive, so if you ever lose one of my emails, for instance, the one that announces the date of the final exam, you can come back to this email archive and look it up again. So the email archive is a courtesy to you, so you can keep track of all the emails that I send to you throughout the course. I often have a resources folder as well. Normally, I don't put things in there for students except for the PowerPoint slides. I'm a big believer in PowerPoint slides, and I try to make a PDF of all of the handouts and put them up so that you can download them and take your notes on them. And that is a quick tour of all of the tools I'm going to be using in my course. I may add new tools from time to time, and if so, I'll make sure that I provide you with a discussion of how they work. Now that you've had a look at some of the tools that I use, let's take a look at the content. As I said earlier, I have a brand new web page for each week of the course. Each week I have a little video. It's always relevant and hopefully sometimes pretty funny. That has to do with each week's content, so please make sure to click on the videos. They're between 1 and 2 minutes. I also have many narrated PowerPoints. To access them, just click on the link. If they're on screencast, you can make them larger by clicking the full size button, and you play them just by clicking the arrow. You can always get back by clicking this little reset button on the top of the screen. That will take you back to the initial page that you were looking at. The back buttons are kind of problematic in Laulima. So you'd watch the first, second, and third PowerPoints, then sometimes I make videos available. Which are also part of the requirements for this course. Then again, you click this little reset button and go back. And for some of the courses, I also have flash-based vocabulary cards. So for instance, here you can access the vocabulary links here. And if I do have vocabulary cards, you can look at the word here and look at the definition by clicking this part. And you can go on to the next one by clicking on the arrows, etc. I also have quizzes. As I said earlier, they're in the Tasks, Tests, and Survey window, and also links to our class Twitter account and any other homework. At the bottom of each page, I give you a little preview of next week's class. So you would work your way through this material. Because this is an American Bar Association approved paralegal program, I have 2.5 hours worth of content for you every week. That's a requirement. So you have some time for a discussion board, some time for a quiz, and then you have narrated PowerPoints and videos and other things to read. That makes up the content of the course. It's particularly important in Law 101, as we don't have a textbook. I hope this will make you feel more comfortable with going through my website, whether you're taking one of my online, face-to-face, or hybrid courses. And I look forward to seeing you in class.